everyone, this is GodzillaWolf1, and I am back with another episode of Scribblenauts, and I'm back in my Super Matthew costume from last week, which still looks utterly ridiculous, and I can still do this. But anyway, let's continue on, and there's still the caveman riding a dragon with a machine gun that totally won't somehow destroy a major city at some point. Now we're in... Okay, we're back here. Okay, that's interesting. So we apparently just warped back here. Okay. Well, we still got three places we can go, so let's go to a volcano. Oh, the puns. This game has almost as much love for puns as MLP does. Only they're not all horse puns. Okay, we got a cockatrice over there. Speaking of MLP, cockatrice. Okay, here we got a minotaur and a giant. Give me something to play fetch with my dog. Dexterous fast behemoth. Okay. Okay. There you go. Okay, what's your... Oh, hello, Frodo. I was supposed to throw into this volcano. Okay, we're apparently at Mount Doom now. Huh, what do you know? Frodo actually did it that time. Man, didn't need Gollum to, tackle himself into a volcano, provide him with a spark of life. Okay. Okay. That didn't work. Apparently I just needed an actual spark. Oh, it was a phoenix, okay. Help me temper this magic sword. Well, tempering... Okay, then. Ballistic Spectacular Invincible Golden Excalibur. Well, how can I not take it with a name like that? Okay, what do we have over here? A cockatrice. So the cockatrice's petrifying gaze. There you go. Now think about what you've done. Invincible crown. Okay. Ah, okay. Yeah, I don't need it. Here you go. And you guys are going through a portal. Okay, see you later. Now you are playing with portals. I struck ooze. Find a way to contain it for me. Well, it works with ghosts. I mentioned I'm not the best speller. Because I'm not. Okay, whatever. Bottle. There you go. Okay, okay then! That was all you, dude. That was not me accidentally doing something that went horribly wrong. Throw dinner. What are you? You're a cannibal. Oh, there you go. Seriously, what is with this game and cannibals? Why are there so many cannibals? A turkey. Hello, turkey. No, but I can't leave my egg alone. There you go. Oh, you're a vulture. Oh dear, that's not gonna end well, but there's nothing I can really do about that. Okay, so that still leaves two left. Oh, hello, evil private, I'm assuming, is one of my relatives. Okay, probably too big. There you go. Okay, here's just some ice. Or... oh, okay, that's why. Okay, then. This is kind of irritating. You know, I have a bad feeling about this, given his first reaction to that was an evil laugh, and to try to shoot me with it. And now you froze it. Now you froze yourself. Okay. And there's your evil lair. Oh, you have a good time, one of my siblings. Oh, here you are. This was a terrible vacation spot. Help me ward off dehydration. There you go. So why a dryad would pick up? Yeah, she said it's a terrible vacation spot. Okay, so that's all the little ones. Now let's go for the big starites. Ward off the four horsemen of the apocalypse. Okay, we're canceling the apocalypse now, which was a double reference in a way. Okay, so we're wearing a tiki mask now. Deter the four horsemen. Stop the disease brought on by pestilence. There. I defeated you with the power of modern medicine.
Ew.
Okay, war. Solution was a dove. So, makes sense. Okay, here we have famine. Okay, simple solution to that. They ate the entire restaurant. That is actually really impressive. You guys should be on an eating contest. Oh dear. Just Despite filling their stomachs, death has taken them. Find a way to ward off death by bringing them back to life. Okay.
Ouch!
Okay. Good. God brings people back to life in this game. I would have been worried if he couldn't. I mean, of course you could solve it. If they wanted to, they could make God like the go-to answer to everything because he's literally God, so... I mean, it kind of comes with being omnipotent when you're in that situation, so... And you can't have the player be omnipotent or else... Well, actually, can I actually give myself the adjective omnipotent? Also, I'm frozen, apparently. Yes, I actually can give myself the word omnipotent. Okay, so you can make the player omnipotent in this game, apparently. Help save the village from a volcano that's about to erupt. I hope I don't have to do it by being sacrificed to the volcano god. Can I make a volcano god? I think I probably can. Okay, what's our situation here? Volcano is going to erupt. Help save the shaman's village by sacrificing objects to the volcano goddess. Write 3 bounties of the earth to throw into the volcano. Always wanted to use the word cornucopia to solve a problem. Now's my chance. Apparently that didn't help. Okay. Gotta do something weird at least. Okay, a rutabaga. Now, what does the volcano goddess want now? I'm still angry. Maybe it's unhappy with our dependence on technology. Try to appease it by writing more sacrifices. I'm sure the volcano goddess is big enough she needs a giant laptop. I don't know if giving an angry volcano goddess a battleship is a good idea, but here we go. It did not immediately explode. And as for the last one... Oh, come on, that was a perfectly good kitchen sink. Don't see a Ferrari here. Then again, that's a license. Oh wait, where was that it? Fenrir? Okay, then, just do something. We'll give her a sports car. Let's see if she likes that. Jeez, picky lady! Come on, volcano goddess! Volcano keeps writing, perhaps the volcano goddess wants a monetary sacrifice. Create a donation for the volcano. Okay, let's give her the gold! Jeez, this is one hard to appease volcano god! Okay. Huh. Offering does not work. Now the volcano goddess has appeared and is demanding a love interest, right? A mate she will be happy with. Here, have a volcanic god. Now we have now that she has a love interest. Who's on fire. Okay. I mean, she's also on fire, but... Okay, and that's the end of that level. Let's continue. And see what's next. Let's just warp, because we got two places left. Camel Case Oasis and Tide Reef. Let's go to Tide Reef, because it looks like it'll be short. Oh, look, an octopus with one eye. Aw, it's a dolphin that's stuck in a net. Wait, I'm trapped. Get me out of this. Or is that a porpoise? Are you a dolphin or a porpoise? You are a porpoise. That's a porpoise, and I did that on purpose. Oh, it's following me. Okay. My light is too dim to attract prey. Add an adjective to me. Okay. There you go. Okay, hello, sibling. Help, I'm running out of air. That is a serious problem. That did not help. Okay. If I've learned anything in cartoons, all you need to remain perfectly fine underwater is a snorkel. Okay. There, now you're fully equipped to be underwater. What were you doing at the bottom of the ocean without water? I mean, without air. And you're in a car. Okay. Cherub fish. The clam has the perfect coral for my collection. I'm gonna keep this Super Excalibur. Some of our home has been destroyed. Create something to help the reef grow. Regrow. Okay, we'll go with regenerating coral. That's a sea cucumber. I'll just make you another reef.
Ouch!
Which apparently somehow got hurt falling down. Sea urchin. Okay, and that completed this level. Oh, here you go. Here's a pearl. Are you happy now? Okay, anyway, that's where we're going to end this episode, which is kind of ironic because we ended up doing a fire level and an ice level, a water level at the same time. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, like, comment, and subscribe. This sword is amazing. See you guys next time. Bye! I still don't have a catchphrase.